We live in a world of birds. Wherever we are, they are too. And of all nature's creatures, they're the only ones that share their lives with all of us.
There you go.
It's a connection that really could last a lifetime. Because no matter where you go, there are birds about, even in the most urban of settings.
You see this bird up in the sky?
I'm Willem Lang, and today I'm going to take you on a journey to places familiar and lands exotic. And along the way, we'll meet people who, in their own way, share the birding experience.
I think it's genetic. I just love birds. One of the things that is easy to show to another people, because everywhere when you be, there will be a bird.
Our story begins near the end of a winding gravel road. This centuries-old home in Center Sandwich, New Hampshire, is well known by school kids, their parents, and even their parents.
This is year 31 for me. How can we tell what kind of birds are with us?
It's a sanctuary where Sarah Zuccarelli teaches visitors about birds.
Because of the sounds, exactly, the songs, that's true. The natural world is a miracle a mile a minute.
Once you take a microphone like this and aim it at a bird and put the headphones on, and it is just you and that veery, it's a slippery slope. You fall into this black hole.
I'm going to show him to you really quickly. You see that green on his back?
I mean, a lot of these kids come from high-density housing areas. So, you know, they don't have many opportunities to actually touch base face-to-face with wildlife. So this brings the wildlife to them.
Have a nice trip. Come on.
It's really the outdoors is where I study all this. It all comes from the direct link with the outdoors. And so that's really just the whole motivation for it, is trying to make people feel like they're out there. In my way, I try to share with people what enjoyment I get from being in the outdoors.
Welcome to Ometepe, Nicaragua. Ometepe is an Aztec word meaning two hills. And you can see today what the Aztecs saw, two volcanoes rising out of Lake Nicaragua. Now, once we cross to the far shore in our ferry boat, we'll go inland for a few miles and meet some people who are bridging the Americas through birds.
We're learning about another place on the planet that's connecting us by the birds.
Christine's a teacher from Virginia, and Mary runs the Smithsonian Institution's Bridging the Americas program. It connects school kids in the United States with students in Central America.
We thought how cool it would be if we could connect kids in the places where the birds are for one part of the year with kids in the locations where the birds are for other parts of the year.